Guess it's that time of the week again. It's Tuesday. This past week has been so busy for me. Just classes are getting hectic. I have a shit ton of interviews coming up for internships. I have to do laundry, I have homework to do, projects, sleep, meetings. Ugh. I can't even think about all the stuff that I have to do this week and next week and the rest of the semester and all that. But I just got back Sunday night from one of the best weekends ever. My boyfriend and I, we celebrated our first year anniversary last week. It was October 2nd. And we decided to go to Pittsburgh to celebrate the weekend. And he hadn't been to Pittsburgh in many years, and I've never been there, so it was an awesome experience. I got this necklace. I'm gonna see if I can make it over there. Wait, there it is. It's not that easy to see, I guess, from there. I'll put a picture of it up. It was awesome. I have a little teddy bear by my stuffed animals, and he gave me a screwdriver. It's kind of an inside joke. Hysterical, but I'm gonna give myself a minute to recollect my thoughts, and you can see pictures of Pittsburgh. It's a lonely old night, and I put my arms around you. It's a lonely old night, 'cause it's made for two lonely people. Well, that was pictures of my trip, and I had so much fun. It was such a great weekend. It was just remarkable and amazing, and I was so sad to have to go home. Like, I cried when I had to go home. But there's actually something I wanted to talk about. I guess a lot of it just has to do with faith and Christianity and religion. I'm not going to get into too much. I know not that many people want to hear about the religious spiel, but I found God again for the first time in a little less than 2 years, a couple weeks ago. I don't really want to get into too much detail, but I had a really bad experience with a Christian group on campus. They were very cult-like. They were like your stereotypical high-pressure group. So I just kind of wanted nothing to do with it. And when I left the group for preventative measures. And I just basically turned my back on it. I'm like, screw this. I was just, like, I trusted you guys. You really sucked me in when I first got here. And you basically just turned out to be a piece of crap. So it really turned me away from something I really enjoyed. I was very active in my church back home. I was baptized, communion, and confirmed. I was a lector, which was a reader for my church. I was the youngest lector by 35 years when I started, and I kind of silently started the movement for younger people to start lecturing. And yeah, it was all stripped with me when I got here and left the Christian group. And it was just such a balance for me. Like, it really kept me on 2 feet, I guess. But my friend Gretel, she's in a lot of my classes with me, we're in the same major. She was telling me about the group she was part of and how they're going to go to this bonfire and just hang out. And they have their services every Tuesday. They volunteer at the football games. They're involved with the big philanthropy here on campus. Like, they do everything. And I told her I was very hesitant because of my experience. And I swear to God, the girl looked like she was going to cry. She was... her heart broke into, like, itty-bitty pieces and was like, yeah, that should never happen. So She's like, well, you don't have to come. It'd be complete. She goes, I'm not going to pressure you, but if you want to, it'd be so much fun. Plus, we'd start hanging out more. So I started going, and it's been amazing. Like, everyone is so welcoming. People higher up in the group, like the minister and the pastor, know my situation and how hesitant I was coming back to anything Christian related. And it just ended up being fantastic. And sorry, I had Niamh come up. My best friend's studying in the Netherlands right now, so he just IM'd me, and I'm like, if I'm gonna talk to him, he's 6 hours away, so I'm gonna try to at the same time. But then I went to my first church session last week, and the guy was talking about these little nobodies who end up making the biggest deal in your life or make such an impact. And I thought long and hard about that. And actually, I didn't really take that much time because I knew exactly who came to mind. My friend Gretel came up because she was just doing anything. She was treating me the same way she would treat anyone else. And she's like, hey, you really should come check this out. This girl has the biggest heart in the world, let me tell you. And just through her being there and not pressing issues and just trying to be supportive, she really affected my life in a big way. And she helped me get something back that was such a big part of my life. So I will always thank her for that, because she's, I guess, that person who, the ordinary person can change someone's life. And she's done that for me this past semester, so far, this past couple weeks, and I'm so thankful for her. But that's about all I'm gonna say. I'm tired. I'm gonna go relax before, I'm part of Christian Student Fellowship here on campus now, and we have a meeting in, 2 hours, so I'm gonna, relax if I have to go to that. I don't know if we still do challenges here, but I'm gonna try to pose out a challenge and see if anyone wants to do it. Tell me about someone in your life who has made an impact on you. Try to keep out, a significant other or a parent. I'm trying to go from, an acquaintance or a friend or a friend of a friend or a complete stranger. It's just basically that tell me about something that someone has done that may be insignificant or ordinary to them but has really touched you. So, I'm peacing out, and I will see you all next Tuesday. Bye!